Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Team Swift Flight Readiness Review. Today, we'll be looking at all of the details and information related to our aircraft, Nebula. Starting off with an introduction to the representing team heading towards SUAS 2024, we have Hamad Kaisar, who has 3 years of experience as a GCS operator for Team Swift. Moving on, we have Abdullah Rizwan, who also has 3 years of experience as a safety pilot for the team. We also have Aiza, who has 2 years of experience with Team Swift and is an airdrop coordinator. Let's move on towards the technicalities, where we've got Manoor Ahmed, who's got 3 years of experience as the electrical systems lead at Team Swift. We have Rida, who has a year's worth of experience as the junior mechanical supervisor for Team Swift. And last but not least, we have Ashir, who has 3 years of experience as a senior mechanical supervisor for Team Swift. Let's kick things off with a quick run-through of the requirements and acceptance criteria for these missions. We're talking about competence, folks, the nuts and bolts of what makes these aerial escapades tick. First up, we've got timeline, coming in at 10%. We're talking 15 minutes to set up shop, 30 minutes for the mission itself, and another 10 to tear it down. And don't forget, there's only one timeout, so use it wisely. Next on the list, we've got operator skill, at 30%. These folks are the cream of the crop, with skills sharper than a hawk's talons. They're the only ones who can maneuver those drones like nobody's business, detecting objects autonomously, and avoiding collisions like it's second nature. Now let's talk airdrop precision, the grit and gravy of these hair-raising missions, taking up a whopping 50% of the score. We've got airdrop red-eye to hit, obstacles to dodge, and boundaries to stay within. And let's not forget about that drone speed, clocking in at a swift 42 feet per second. With a minimum flight time of 24 minutes and an average flight time of 26 minutes, it's enough to make your head spin faster than a whirlwind in Kansas. Finally, we've got operational excellence, clocking in at a cool 10%. Now, when we say operational excellence, we mean teams that run tighter than a well-oiled machine. We're talking professionalism, folks, attention to safety, and quick reactions to any mid-air mishaps. So there you have it, the breakdown on what it takes to soar to new heights in the world of aerial missions.
Now, let's take a look at the system overview.
Let's start by taking a peek at our flight system. Our flight system is a well-oiled machine, starting off with manual control operation, folks. Our safety pilots got their hands full with access to live camera feeds, instruments, and the manual control system, ready to take the reins at a moment's notice. They ensure smooth sailing and safe operation throughout the flight. But don't think for a second that we're flying solo, folks. Our autopilot system, led by the Cube Orange Plus, takes charge of the skies with precision and poise. Nebula is a master of autonomous flight, so our safety pilot can kick back and relax while their drone takes care of business up above. Last but not least, we've got our onboard processing system, powered by the one and only NVIDIA Jetson Nano. This little powerhouse is on the lookout for targets in the scan zone, pinpointing their coordinates and giving the autopilot the green light to make the perfect airdrop. Let's talk about the aircraft design and testing. As we embark on the captivating tale of our quest for the perfect airframe, in our tireless pursuit of aviation excellence, we delved into the realms of fixed wings, VTOLs, and multirotors. Fixed wings, with their sleek efficiency and lightning-fast speeds, initially captured our imagination. Yet, alas, their inability to hover for airdrop operations left us yearning for more. Next, we turned our gaze towards VTOLs, with their tantalizing promise of vertical takeoff and landing prowess. However, their precarious stability gave us pause, steering us away from this intricate path. And so, dear friends, we found ourselves down to the realm of multirotors. While quadcopters beckoned with their agility, we ultimately dismissed them due to their limited payload capacity. Ah yes, the burdensome weight of compromise. But fear not, for in our pursuit of aerial glory, we stumbled upon the hexacopter design. With its rock-solid stability, payload prowess, and reliability, it was a match made in engineering heaven. Nebula is powered by none other than the Hobbywing X6 brushless motors, feather light at 72 grams each. With carbon fiber arm tubes measuring 30 millimeters in diameter, we're talking strength, durability, and safety all rolled into one sleek package. And let's not forget about the unsung heroes of the sky, the propellers. The UAV is equipped with 23-inch propellers crafted from carbon fiber, tough as nails. Nebula stands tall and proud at an impressive height of 730 mm with a wheelbase spanning 1290 mm and don't even get a start on the landing gear, measuring a whopping 590 mm in length and circumference. The UAV is built with rapid development and iteration in mind, featuring a fully modular fuselage. From the arms, battery bay to even our proprietary airdrop mechanism, everything can be swapped easily to test several alternatives. To provide superior control and maneuverability, Nebula is configured as a hexacopter with a maximum thrust of 12 kg per axis. This means that Nebula can not only fly the required mission quickly, but also evade obstacles effectively. Let's dive into the aerodynamics of Nebula. We've meticulously optimized the motors to balance thrust generation and power usage. Through simulations and fabricating 3 frames, we settled on the one that provided optimal cooling to the onboard processor while maintaining low drag during flight. And now for the real test, the flight trials. After extensive testing, Nebula, with an average speed of 29 miles per hour, successfully completed the specified 15-mile flight distance carrying a 1,500-gram payload without needing to land for battery reloads. Our batteries sustained this flight over our safety minimum of 20%. Let's see how Swift has done the airdrop design and testing for the competition. Last year's perforated parachute method may have done the trick, but let's face it folks, it was about as accurate as a blindfolded pirate with a cannon. So in true Team Swift fashion, we've gone back to the drawing board and crafted a solution fit for the skies of SUAS 2024. A relay mechanism in tandem with the parachute was tested. The parachute would be deployed a couple of seconds prior to touchdown, softening the landing. But this idea was rejected after unpredictable landings due to wind direction and speed. A free-falling protective bottle cover was then considered, but it provided unreliable results, often damaging the payload. A motor wind system that will lower all payloads was also tested, but it did not make the cut due to its excessive weight and complexity. But in the end, it was a simple yet effective default bearing and shaft mechanism that emerged victorious. Five individual tapered shafts, crafted from the finest PLA through 3D printing, stand tall and proud, ready to revolutionize the airdrop game. With high tensile strength, nylon string wrapped around each shaft, and a trusty servo at the helm, we're poised to deliver payloads with precision and grace like never before. But that's not all. Our meticulously designed tapered shafts are engineered to control drop speed, the larger diameter of the shaft ensuring a rapid descent, and the smaller diameter making the touchdown smooth for our precious cargo as it makes its journey back to solid ground. When that signal is received, that servo releases the shaft and down goes the payload. Each payload gets its very own bubble wrap hug for that extra touch of protection. Now let's talk performance. Through countless manual trials and rigorous testing, our airdrop system has proven itself time and time again with a 100% accuracy rate across 27 manual tests and an impressive 95% accuracy for ODLC drops. We're setting the standard for precision in the skies. And just how fast are we talking? Well, on average, a drop from a height of 75 feet takes a mere 15 seconds to complete. Now that's what we call efficient, but wait, there's more. Our successful drops maintain their position within the designated area radius a staggering 100% of the time, ensuring that our payloads land right where they're supposed to each and every time. Now let's dive right into the heart of the matter, the autopilot system that's keeping Nebula on course and on target. At the core of our drone's control system lies the PixHawk Cube, a marvel of modern technology packed with all the gizmos and gadgets you could ever dream of. With its onboard sensors including accelerometers, gyroscopes and magnetometers, Nebula's as steady as a rock even in the wildest of weather. The PixHawk Cube teams up with the Jetson Nano, a match made in heaven if ever there was one. With our ODLC algorithms leading the way, Nebula is like a guided missile locked onto its target, ready to swoop in and conquer with precision. And down here at our ground station, we've got Mission Planet, the brains behind the operation. With its open source magic, we're mapping out waypoints, analyzing telemetry data, and plotting our course to victory with the finesse of a seasoned navigator. Thanks to our autopilot system, Nebula's not just a bird in the sky, it's a marvel of modern engineering. With automated takeoffs and landings, fine-tuned parameters, and precision navigation courtesy of our optical character recognition system, there's no mission too tough for our trusty drone. And let's not forget about our testing phase, folks. We've logged 36 flights, with 29 flights aimed at hitting a whopping 400 waypoints. And wouldn't you know it, we hit the mark with 100% accuracy and 0% error.
Let's check out the ODLC now.
Let's kick things off with a look at our camera setup. Feast your eyes on the Tata T10X 3-axis gimbal camera, a real powerhouse with its 10x optical zoom capabilities. But it's not just about zooming in, folks. We're talking stability too, thanks to that trusty gimbal keeping our shots steady as a rock. And how do we ensure top-notch image quality, you ask? Well, we've got our secret weapon, the Temporal Smoothing Algorithm, or TSA for short. It's like magic, turning those blurry images into crystal-clear masterpieces fit for a museum. With the gimbal taking care of vibrations and the TSA working its magic, we're seeing a resolution boost like never before. From 0.1 megapixel per shape at 2x zoom to a reconstructed resolution of 0.6 megapixels per shape with 50 passes of the TSA stack. It's like we've upgraded from a dinghy to a battleship overnight. Now let's dive into the heart of our operation, the algorithm. We're talking model training, object detection, classification, and localization, all wrapped up in one neat package. And how do we train our algorithms, you ask? With a little help from our friend. DJISI makes sure we have plenty of images to play with, updating our measly 50,000 images to 100,000. Musaddis is responsible for training our in-house algorithm. We made a captcha to label our dataset and Dai flips and spins our dataset till it's brand new. It's like having a team of virtual trainers whip our algorithms into shape. But we don't stop there. We've got Glow Up, kicking things into high gear, weeding out the weak images and extracting the cream of the crop. It's like having a digital assistant sift through a pile of treasure to find the real gem. The basic working is as follows. First, it discards weak images, extracting the relevant pixels and then picking interesting regions. To discard weak images, we simply have certain events, like gimbal readjustment that the algorithm listens for. If the discard events come, we simply do not process the image. This keeps the onboard Jetson Nano running cool and greatly reduces the number of false positives given by the ODLC stack. Next, we process the image to extract important pixels.
We can discard the set of pixels that are too small, and finally we have extracted the shapes that we will be classifying. And when it comes to object classification, we've got Dactyr on our side. With a little chroma masking and adaptive thresholding, we're sifting through shapes like a prospector hunting for gold. FIDIM employs the who moments, whereas Orbs utilizes key points. Now coming to localization, the final piece of the puzzle. With the field of view method and a dash of triangulation, we're pinpointing our targets like a seasoned navigator charting a course through uncharted waters. We then verify that the reading is actually correct, and if we think it's legit, we go do the airdrop. And how do we know if it all works like a charm? Through rigorous testing, of course. With 12 ODLC test flights under our belt and a false positive rate of just 5%, we're flying high and aiming true. So buckle up, folks, because we're just getting started on this high-flying adventure. And there you have it, the inside scoop on our imaging and ODLC systems that'll have you seeing the skies in a whole new light. Until next time, keep your eyes on the horizon and your algorithms finely tuned.
Now let's pay a visit to the communications, design, and testing.
Now hold on to your hats, because we're about to dive into the nitty-gritty of seamless connectivity, where every bit and byte counts more than a pocketful of pennies. Picture this, folks, you're soaring through the skies like a superhero on a sugar rush, but what's keeping you connected to the ground? Why, it's our trusty communication system, the Robin to your Batman, the Jelly to your peanut butter. Now our safety pilot is not just twiddling their thumbs up there, oh no, they're wielding the Skydroid H12 remote controller. With its 2.4 GHz long-range radio system and frequency hopping spread spectrum technology, it's like playing a game of hot potato with your data, only without the burns. But wait, there's more. This bad boy's got one heck of an operating range. We're talking 18 miles of communication goodness, enough to keep you chatting with ground control even if you accidentally fly to the moon and back. Benchmarks have shown sustained throughput of up to 50 megabits per second, enabling seamless streaming of high-definition video feeds and telemetry data. Now let's talk telemetry. Our telemetry of choice is the HolyPro SIK Telemetry Radio V3, a real mouthful of a name for a real powerhouse of a gadget. Straight out of the box, it's got a range of 300 meters. But why stop there when you can slap on a patch antenna and extend the range? It has a maximum output power of 500 MW and a received sensitivity of negative 117 dBm. And folks, we've put the communication system through its paces, let us tell ya.
We sent our trusty UAV, Nebula, up over 1,000 feet and more than 5 miles, and you know what? Not a single glitch in sight.
Now let's check out obstacle avoidance, design, and testing. So here's the scoop to dodge those pesky obstacles in the sky. We're referring to LiDAR technology, folks. The LiDARs in question are the Benuaque TF Mini S LiDARs. Why, you ask? Since these are compatible with the Pixhawk Cube Orange and fit snug as a bug in a rug with the mission planner. Plus, they've got a range of about 12 meters, resolution of 5 millimeters, and a field of view of 3.6 degrees. They're hooked up to the mission planner's horizontal and vertical bendy ruler algorithm. A fancy name for a darn clever bit of code. By employing two sensors, we achieve a broader detection range and a finer resolution of the surroundings. Now with this fancy setup up and running, we threw everything and the kitchen sink at it, from stationary obstacles to moving targets. With a whopping 85% accuracy rate, we're more confident than ever that no obstacle can stand in our way. Now let's take a look at the alternatives considered. We pitted the Jetson Nano against the Raspberry Pi, the Nano designed specifically for AI applications due to its GPU and CUDA cores, and so it came on top. Flight controllers and propulsion motors got their time in the spotlight too. The QPilot Orange Plus stole the show with its user-friendly interfaces and hardware that would make a tech geek weak in the knees, while the CUAV X7 was rejected due to its inferior processing speeds and hardware. The Hobbywing X-Rotor was picked over the T-Motor U8 since the latter was deemed unviable as it had comparatively inferior thrust and less motor efficiency. LiPo batteries were picked over lithium batteries due to their ruggedness and featherlight weight. The two 6S batteries coupled in series, they keep our Nebula soaring through the skies longer than a flock of geese on vacation.
Let's talk about a very important factor, the safety risks and mitigation.
First up on the safety checklist, we've got fire hazard prevention. Ain't nothing scarier than a drone going up in flames like a 4th of July fireworks display. So what's our secret? Reliable batteries and some good old-fashioned fire analysis. We're talking about batteries that won't let you down when the going gets hot. Now let's talk about those electrical components. We aren't letting them rattle around like loose change in a piggy bank. No, sir, we're talking about proper covering and fixing so they don't go wandering off mid-flight, fabricating mounts wherever necessary. Dodging collisions like a pro with multiple aircraft practice and LiDAR tech, we're planning our flight paths and keeping an eye on the weather, avoiding stormy skies like the plague. Components stay intact with careful planning and double checks before takeoff. No major meltdowns here. Crystal clear video feed? You bet. The gimbals and cameras work together to reduce blare like magic. And lastly, keeping our payload safe and sound with bubble wrap and smart strap designs, touching down smoother than a feather on a gentle breeze. So there you have it, folks. The lowdown on keeping our hexacopter flying high and safe as can be.
Let's pay a visit to the mission testing. Now let's kick things off with a look at the backbone of any successful mission, the timeline. With Nebula scoring an average of 90%, this trusty bird set up camp in just 30 minutes, tore down in 10, and soared through the skies for an average of 26 minutes per flight. And with similar flight times expected at the competition, Swift's got the clock on their side. With mandatory GCS and safety pilot in tow, Team Swift navigated their way through last year's waypoints with finesse, achieving a solid average score of 70 in the operator skill segment. But what's a mission without a payload, you ask? With an impressive 100% success rate in landing within the 20-foot radius, Swift's payloads found their mark every time, ensuring a smooth and steady descent to solid ground. With clear communication signals and pre-flight checklists in hand, Team Swift soared to new heights of operational excellence, securing an average score of 80 and ensuring that every mission is a safe and successful one. With waypoint accuracy soaring at 100%, airdrop accuracy hitting an impressive 100% and ODLC accuracy standing strong at 95%. Looking into our performances from 4 full mission tests, whether it be the skills of the operator or the magic in our automation team's fingertips, we have scored high points and have proven time and time again that we're a force to be reckoned with in the skies. Now we move towards the proof of safe flight. First, we have the flight showing manual takeoff, and Nebula going 1,000 feet away from our safety pilot and landing successfully. 1,000 feet waypoint. Landing. Next up, Nebula completes an autonomous flight, getting 200 feet from the safety pilot, and the pilot switching over to manual mode and landing the helicopter safely. Finally, Nebula completes a mission, flying 5 miles fully loaded, flying waypoints with the error configured in the mission. Flight. Landing. From showcasing our state-of-the-art technology to detailing our meticulous testing procedures, it's clear that Nebula is primed and ready to take on the skies. With our cutting-edge imaging and ODLC systems paired with top-notch hardware and algorithms, we're confident in our ability to excel in the competition. So buckle up, folks, because Nebula is geared up and raring to go.